Now, today's cricket from Lord's, here with the highlights, is Tony Lewis.
The NatWest Trophy, the knockout competition. Dermot Reeve recovered from that collision with Neil Burns to lead Warwickshire to victory by 52 runs over Somerset in last month's semi-final. In the other semi, Alan Wells was the star. His unbeaten century helped Sussex recover from 47 for 4 to beat Glamorgan by 3 wickets at home. So today's final is between two counties whose captains very definitely lead from the front, Dermot Reeve of Warwickshire and Alan Wells of Sussex. Hello and welcome to the highlights. Both of these sides, by the way, have won the NatWest Trophy before, Sussex in 1986 and Warwickshire in 89. 60 overs aside and an early toss for the start at 10:30. I was out there with the captains, Alan Wells and Dermot Reeve.
So Warwickshire have won the toss and will field first, Owen.
Correct, Tony.
Now, you've had a bit of experience in these matches. You seem to have appeared for both sides along the way.
Yeah, I appeared for 86 with Alan when Sussex beat Lancashire, which was a great day, and then again for Warwickshire in 89.
How have you settled your side today?
Andy Moles is back in from the scorecard from the semi-final, and unfortunately Trevor Penny misses out, which is bad luck for Trevor. But he's been out for a few weeks with a shoulder injury and we haven't got a lot of form to go on, but we'll miss him in the field.
And Alan, what about your side?
Same as the semi-final, same lineup.
And what do you see out here for a pitch?
Might be a little bit of moisture on it, that's the usual sort of thing, September at Lord's, but we're quite confident, we're looking forward to the day.
A number of sides have had difficulty losing the toss and batting first.
That's right, but we'll try and change the norm.
Good, good luck to you both.
Thank you very much.
So let's take a look at the teams. Experienced openers there with Smith and Athey for Sussex, and stroke makers Speight, Wells and Stevenson in the middle. Ian Salisbury, the leg spinner in the side. And Warwickshire, well, they have 6 bowlers available, 1 spinner, Neil Smith, and a mixture of batting. But Dermot Reeve is quite a key character as an all-rounder in the middle there. The umpires, Harold Bird and Mervyn Kitchen, with a third umpire, Alan Whitehead. Warwickshire winning the toss, are fielding first. Let's join the first ball, small bowls to Smith. Oh. These are important overs for the opening batsmen, not only for their own wickets, but for also for the dressing room. They will be looking for better shots than that. Well wide of the off stump. That was glorious. Positively regal.
And Vic looks full of energy this morning. That was a good shot.
Well, 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 Bill Athey goes for naught to a nothing ball and even less of a shot. And a scrambling catch. It's a strange sequence of cricket.
Yes, Bill Athey will disappoint you with that. It's a marvellous season for Sussex. They must have knocking on for 1,500 runs in first class. And really, Tim Munton's pace. Really a nothing ball, really. In fact, he fell himself, so I think it was accidental ball, really. But it's got the wicket, and that's what Warwickshire wanted.
So, 4 for 1. A That's another strong shot. She's going to bowl there to David Smith. He keeps clobbering the ball through cover, square, all day. Well, that was a thundering shot.
Nothing's fate was certainly very quick onto this one. It was short, easy first pitch, but really whacked that away through mid-wicket.
It was a thumping shot, but it's played off the front foot. It's extraordinary to see someone leaping onto the front foot, whacking across the line, especially when the bowler is a tall seam bowler who has played for England. Well, he's full of strokes. Front foot sweep, now neatly back and across and driving.
Yes, I read some great reports about Martin Speight. Tremendous stroke player. I must admit, I've never seen him make a big score. Certainly played some interesting shots so far this morning.
That's well bowled. Prompting a similar stroke.
Yes, Glatson getting that ball there to move away nicely. Went like a big leg break there. Unfortunate not to get a wicket.
That was amazingly taken. I think the keeper started going the wrong way first time. Must have been some late movement away.
Well, we said if Glatson Small could bowl some of the deliveries that he bowled at the left-hander batsman, they'd be very good to the right-hander. He just bowled a couple on the trot there. Beautiful deliveries. No reward for them.
Well, look at this. What a difficult customer to bowl to. David Gower alongside me, and you must have seen some of this, David.
I've seen Martin Speight play some extraordinary shots over the years. He's not short of confidence, that much we can say, treating Tim Munton as a very ordinary medium pacer. A lovely shot. He's kept those hands going high. He's hit straight through the line of the ball and straight down the ground.
Work is inch perfect. What a shot! How many times have we seen virtually a straight six in the first hour of a NatWest final? Brings the 50 up.
That would have brought a few people to their feet as well. It's a glorious shot. It's normally a lot later in the day that you see these sorts of shots attempted. He does play it very well. Keeps his eye, his head down, eye on the ball. And there's a dead straight follow through.
And again. It's three times he's done this. This time it's only four.
Only four maybe, but it's a big problem for Tim Munton. Tim Munton had that early success getting Bill Athey out, but since then, he might have regretted it. Martin Speight has taken a severe liking to him.
Another one. Well, Reid hasn't varied his field placings at all yet. Still two slips. He's got a backward short leg, but just wonder for how long he can let this go. He's hit plenty in the middle, but there's also half a dozen have gone flying past the outside edge.
Well, that's why Dermot Reeves keeping these slips in. It's not a bad ball at all, and Martin Speight had to play at it. That ball pitching just outside off stump, moving away from the right-handed batsman.
again. Not sure where he was hitting that. He was probably intending to start it straight. But it's four. And quite a lot of bat on it.
There aren't too many bats that would actually respond to the previous delivery where the ball went past the outside of the bat by giving themselves room and aiming over extra cover for the next ball.
Smith's gone for the hook, and he can hook. Better delivery, fuller length.
Well, that's the length to bowl. That's where David Smith's a lot more uncertain. Good delivery going across the left-hander.
And another one. It's becoming a nightmare for Dermot Reeve and for Warwickshire. I can't remember a final where I've seen the ball flying to so many parts so quickly.
Well, Sussex getting off to a flyer, and Paul Smith's economy rates in this particular match not looking too brilliant. A question of length and line, and that's just given David Smith room to play that ball away on the offside again. Timed it well.
That was a peculiar bit of cricket.
It's a very slow, slower ball. And almost as if David Smith didn't really pick it up at all. Also swung a little bit, played the draw on it in the end. Little inside edge, through the legs.
It's pre-selected, it's predetermined, it's magnificent to watch. End of the over, 95 for one. Thoughts now from David Gower, and then commentary from Richie Bennett.
Super stuff from Martin Speight. And a little bit of an ooh from the crowd as they thought there might be half a sniff of a caught and bowl there, but it's too firmly hit. And this must be one of the most exhilarating starts we've seen to any cup final at Lord's.
Wouldn't have missed it for the world. Sitting at the back of the commentary box, marvelling at it. In addition to the ones that have whistled past the outside edge of the off stump, or the batsman has played and missed, it has been a terrific morning. Have to do it quick here. And exactly what he is. He's swift between the wickets. It's just a little bit dicey. Look at that.
There's Andy Moles coming in there, and that had got to be... Well, I think that might well have been out with the direct hit. Certainly was very tight. Been a waste of a wicket where these two have played.
First wicket fell at four. So a little inside edge out on the onside has brought up the 100 stand between Smith and Speight. It's been great stuff. Good deep about and Speight. That's a wonderful knock. Common sense as well, not just
get out there and give it a thrash. But beautifully executed. Piper's looking for it. So is the slip. Piper's got it. Well, I suppose it had to come to an end sooner or later, but Spade has certainly got Sussex away to a tremendous start. The second wicket has gone down at 107. We're at the moment only into the 19th over. And that could be innings that swings this final for Sussex in the end. On the other hand, we pointed out a little while ago, get one and might have a few more run along.
Well, it's going to be a good contest between these two, Dermot Reeve, Martin Spaight. One of them, big outswinger there, and trying to play the sweep hit shot. It wasn't really a full sweep shot, right across the line. You can't say it's a good shot with the ball swinging away like that, but he's played some remarkable shots this morning, and great entertainment, but he almost felt sooner or later, if he's going to play that particular shot, it's got to go up in the air. Alan Wells, the Sussex captain, just coming in.
That's the first stroke Alan Wells has unleashed in this innings at Lord's. They've run four. That's just about the longest part of the ground down there. That's a pretty good stroke.
Yes, that's a beautifully controlled stroke. Okay. Dermot Reeve getting the ball to swing out, and he didn't try to hit it again too hard, but perfect timing. Beautifully hit.
Lovely shot. No great effort, but just he made sure that the bat stayed straight throughout the shot.
He does like to be positive for the spinners, Alan Wells. Does use his feet well. As Jet Bannister was saying, lovely straight follow through again, just like Martin Spaight early in the day with the seam bowlers.
Well, this will be tight.
Dickie's asked for the third umpire, which is Alan Whitehead. And first time we've seen this in a final. The run out. Now, what do we see?
Well, as Jet Bannister said, it was always going to be tight. David Smith has run very well this morning. He wanted this one for the 50. Dickie Bird getting into position. And the underarm throw. No great power in the throw. Well, you can see why Dickie Bird called the video evidence.
Frame by frame. Been given not out. And now the acknowledgement of the 50. Eighty balls, six fours. Applause, which is perhaps relieved from the dressing room balcony there. The Sussex supporters. Dickie's dropped the sweater. Something like normal service will be resumed in a minute. Brings up the 150. Well, everything is placed to perfection for Sussex this morning. Anywhere else that would have been two or three. Didn't really get hold of it. One for four, 153 now for two after 29.
wickets were bowled. He deserved that wicket. And a very important one too. Wells was just getting into stride. Out for 33. David Smith is 74. And it's 183 to 3.
Yes, that was certainly make your mind up before he bowled it. No real necessity to do that at the moment. 20 overs left yet. Still 21, but you can see he'd already made his mind up to do that before he bowled. The length was wrong. It was too full a length, and that's why he missed it. You can't really sweep from that length unless you get it on the full toss. This is an interesting move. Franklin Stevenson coming in. I think that's quite right. 21 overs left. And this man can destroy anybody in the space of 10 overs.
Got him. Good catch. A blistering catch there. Smashed at the man at extra cover. It was a pretty good game, and Franklin Stevenson doesn't quite know what to make of it, but that was a super piece of cricket.
I was just saying, Roger Tew was doing a good job getting the ball to swing. Having trouble really middling it. Franklin Stephen went for that one, but the ball's not coming onto the bat very quick now. Just leaving the ground. Not quite keeping the drive down. Neil Smith taking the catch.
Your batsman is Neil Lennon. Is Roger Tew.
Get off the mark with a much nicer shot than that.
Same spot. Not quite the same ball, but same result.
Up.
That's a nice even match now. There's a wicket at one stage that Sussex are running away with it. Warwickshire got themselves back into the game. Sussex have the opportunity of racing ahead now. In the air, drops him. Two runs.
Dominic Oslow, a man out at deep square leg. Neil Lennon hit that quite well, but just about 5 yards to Oslow's right. Very much a chance.
Four runs. That was tipped very firmly through the wicket. It was in the air, but wide of the fielder at mid-wicket.
It was always Neil Lennon's intention to get this over the infield. Just a flick of the wrists, lifts it over mid-wicket. And then on the slope of the ground, just took it down to the boundary very quickly.
Well, that's a colossal blow, my word. I just asked David Guy to talk about the lack of footwork involved in that stroke.
I don't think you need to worry about the feet here, Tony, too much. What you will see is a very full swing of the bat.
Single takes David Smith on 299.
Good looking young player, Neil Lennon. That's a beautiful stroke. serve. Only the sixth century made in NatWest final. The others, Geoffrey Boycott, Clive Lloyd, Vivian Richards, Jeff Cook and Brian Hardy. Brian Hardy's in 1985. Very, very good innings.
Very satisfying moment for David Smith and for his colleagues on the Sussex balcony. It's been a very steady hand. Started fluently. Good partner for Martin Speight when things looked to be going wrong early in the day, but a very good partnership between those two first. And now 100 not out from 162 balls. Now to 266 for four, the current total. Very important now that David Smith makes even more of this and continues on his way for the remaining six overs.
And that's a nice way to continue. Whirling over their arms, and the batsmen have been smashing them to all parts of the park. Century for Neil Lennon. Good effort. Another timely performance from him. Good hit again. Just short of the boundary. They're not mucking around with Tim Munton.
I think David Smith's had enough of the running too. He looks a little bit shattered. Might as well get him in fours. It's easier, he said.
That's a good effort, and it also brings up the 300 for only the second time in NatWest final here at Lord's. Their occasion was Yorkshire when they made over 300 against Surrey. LBW. And Lennon has gone for 58. Quicker ball from Dermot Reeve. He's been mixing them up. Occasional slower one. And a quicker one there has picked up the wicket of Neil Lennon.
Yes, that was like a leg spinner. Perfect length, ran for block roll and well bowled. Did very well at the death, Dermot Reeve. That's been a very entertaining innings from Neil Lennon, right from the first ball.
Your batsman is Keith Greenfield.
Great shot.
Situation that they're seeing a little bit of history here. Previous best 317 for 4 Yorkshire against Surrey, and now Sussex 318 for 5 against Warwickshire. And off the last ball, David Smith has run out, taking the single, or trying to take the single, on a reverse sweep. Players for David Smith, and a standing ovation for him from the crowd who have lost.
Well, it really was a perfectly shaped innings with the opener batting right through. David Smith, the most handsome
124 run out of the last ball. And dashing contributions there from Speight, 50 of 51 balls, Lenham, 58 of 51, and a record total of 321 for six. Hard work for the bowlers. Neil Smith and Roger Toos, I thought, were the pick of them, 1 for 37, 1 for 30. They put the brake on, but a damaging day for Munton. Paul Smith and Dermot Reeves struggled. Gladstone Small, expensive but unlucky. So, 322 required to win at 5.36 runs per over. Let's join Warwickshire now in the fourth over of the innings. Stevenson bowls to Ratcliffe, this 18 for no wicket.
Bowled in, Stevenson strikes, Ratcliffe's gone.
I think a bit of a lazy shot here by Jason Ratcliffe. Didn't really get anywhere with that front foot. The ball just went between bat and pad, but no real movement of the front foot there. He's a big lad, he's over 6 foot, but you can see he's no real stride forward. Had it been, I think he would have played that.
First ball for Dominic Gosler, Stevenson the bowler.
A bad delivery for your first ball.
Caught him. Moles is gone. Bottom edge. Now works in real trouble.
Well, I think it's ironical when you saw the number of times that Gladstone Small went past the outside edge of those outswingers. And here, as I said, Warwickshire starting to play the odd wide one, managing to reach it and getting a little touch through to the keeper. That's what usually happens in a case like this when you're chasing a big score.
Nicely turned away. Beautiful piece of timing. Paul Smith just letting that ball come to him, using the pace of the ball just to work it through the leg side. Wonderful shot there. Again, straight down the ground. That's the great merit of this shot.
Sweet shot.
It's about the first time that Franklin Stevenson has really strayed in line. Angled towards leg stump this time and neatly timed.
Shot. Good square shot, and that beats Ed Giddens. Really good clip off the legs, that. Another fine shot, played deliberately in the air, over mid-wicket. Very healthy sound of bat and ball there. Four more to Paul Smith.
Times we've seen him in Salisbury, he's been a bit inconsistent in length, and again you saw him pitch him very short.
And he has a wicket. Not one that he might have planned precisely, but they all count, I can tell you. Dominic Oster, caught by David Smith of Salisbury. Smith made a century earlier in the day, 25 to Oster from 47 balls.
Well, we've got the full toss we were talking about, and looking to put it away over mid-wicket. Lifted his head fractionally, didn't quite get the middle of the bat. Low down on the bat, and straight to mid-wicket.
The batsman is Asif Din. That's nice placement. I have that man very fine. Very interesting. We'll have another look at that. The question is, if Franklin Stevenson had his hand over the rope, it stayed over the rope when he picked up the ball. Now, there's the hand. Now, up comes the hand. Ah, I think Franklin might have been hardly done by that.
Well, it's nicely bowled. Didn't have a slip and has paid the penalty, and so often happens when a cricketer's out of form and is perhaps slightly unfit. That happens. He bowls a useful delivery and it just costs him four. That's 50 for Paul Smith in a mixture of an innings, but you can only admire the spirit in which he started off, because he came in with his side in trouble of 18 for two, and straight away he decided to attack. And that's the result, 50 off 76 balls.
Well, well, that was a reverse sweep from as wide a delivery as you could see.
Well, as if didn't, he made his mind up to play the reverse sweep, but he bowled it so wide it was nearly impossible to reach.
Got it. By section there, four.
Well, Ian and Salisbury just having a bit of a problem here. Confidence is just going a little.
Another one. Well, Warwickshire needed a big over.
Ooh, to the ball. Well bowled.
Paul Smith is very disappointed. Very disappointed. Franklin Stevenson has zipped that one through at about 3 yards faster than normal. He surprised Paul Smith. And Merv Kitchen has done the rest.
This is exactly what Alan Wells is ordering. Very hard to tell whether it has just nicked the bats. Paul Smith's head turned straight round, which is quite often an indication the batsman thinks he might just have nicked it, following the flight of the ball. But no obvious deviation. There must have been a noise or something as it went past. Paul Smith very disappointed. He's played very well for that 60. Four down then, Warwickshire. 164 they've got now. Dermot Reeve, the captain, arrives at the crease.
Could easily have been so.
Very late on that attempted pull shot. But he's placed it beautifully because he's lobbed it over Franklin Stevenson. Alan Wells can't quite make it, and he's seen Franklin Stevenson coming back towards him, and wouldn't blame him for panicking because there's quite a lot of Franklin Stevenson.
That's a good shot. Really laid his ears back on that one.
And that's his 50. They look for two and turn it down. Pleasant flexibility about Asif Din's batting. He's worked his runs carefully. Gulati, who's had an unlucky start for the day. 200 comes up. He gloved an early catch to the keeper. He's out for naught. Oh, that was close.
It's a beautifully bowled slow ball from Neil Lennon. Hit it in the dark. Dermot Reeve just spotted it in time, but could only, well, just steer the ball inches past the outside of the off stump.
Beautifully struck. That's one of the rare clean blows to the boundary. Predetermined, or he said himself, well, if it's up all around there, I'm going to give it a go. And Neil Lennon just began to struggle a bit there. Well, what was that? It's been called a no ball.
Two runs to the Warwickshire score.
Well, I didn't pick it up. Shape to go underneath as though it was a catch. And ended up sprinting 35 yards and it's gone for four.
Well, that's what we're saying about fielders having problems picking the ball up in this very gloomy conditions.
That'll be called, and is. And it looks as though Vicky's had words, and this will be an official warning, no question of that.
Well, I think that was pretty good, strong umpiring, Jack. I think he was quite right in what he did, and nice to see that. I think he can still be strong when he wants to be.
That's 50 for Dermot Reeve. It's been a good innings. There's the Warwickshire balcony. There's some Warwickshire supporters. It's 450 in this competition. And that's the 100 partnership.
Pay the penalty, you bring fine leg up to put the long on, and you then bowl it and allow them to play the leg glance. Fair, he did go across there a long way and was looking to play it from off stump. It's the way that Dermot Reeve plays, he improvises.
Well, that's gone very, very fast over point's head.
That's the area you've got to be looking to come down the pitch, slice it away on that offside. Don't pull away too much the leg. That's the area where the fielders are going to struggle to pick it up, and certainly if it doesn't go exactly where you think it's going, then you're struggling.
The rate they have to score, 31 needed from 18. One end should have gone to the end where Ashit Din was struggling, but there's always the chance Spate couldn't see him.
Yes, I think he picked the wrong end then. No doubt about it. It was always going to be tight there, but the other end, I think, had a good chance. Good shot.
Great save. Greenfield. Wonderful feeling.
Well, we've seen some poor fielding today from Sussex, but that was absolutely brilliant. And no sliding, he went down with the hand.
Slow ball, and astonishingly, in this light, batsmen all over the world have failed to pick Franklin Stevenson's slower ball. Ashit Din has picked it in the most abysmal light. 296 for 4, 322 needed in all. Ashit Din, a terrific performance from him. Reeves just getting right into his ear now, saying forget about the 100 and just keep laying bat on ball. Just what Warwickshire needed. Sussex must keep them down in this over. That's good cricket.
Oh. Now when you've been out there making 100, that's tremendous running at this stage.
could be out. Spake got him. Gosh, how would he see that in the background? That was brilliantly done. Wasn't a bad shot. Got it just about Auckland meet of the bat. Asif Din, who's played such a wonderful innings here today. 104. And that, for one moment, he must have thought was taking him to 108. And Warwickshire to victory. Spate was the man out there, positioned himself under it. Came fairly flat at him, and it must have come from Blackness.
I thought it was a brilliant piece of fielding. He positioned himself, he didn't panic at all, and he never looked like missing at any time. You can almost tell when the fielder's going to catch the ball. But a marvellous innings by Asif Din there. Tremendous. And a great reception. You remember this day for the rest of his life.
306 for 5. Asif Din out for 104. Roger Toos is the new batsman. Now join Dermot Reavers on 67. Won't get a word for that. It is very, very tense. 16 from 7 balls. Got to get bat or pad on this one. Very well bowled. Very well bowled. Ed Giddens certainly made his debut a couple of years ago. He's now bowled 12 overs for 57 and one wicket. That sounds expensive, but that was a very, very good over. 15 needed from the last over.
Big problem, it's a big ground now. To have to hit a six is difficult, so you've got to get a couple of boundaries.
Big hit. Wonderful strike. Wonderful shot from Dermot Reeve. But again, take two.
Good piece of fielding again. He realised that the batsman at the run in was going to get back. He'd gone so quickly through to the far end. That would have been tight.
Tension, tension. 7 more runs from 3 balls. Dermot Reeve is limping. Already looked a couple of times this match as though he's had cramp. He has a history of leg injury.
And I should think that Roger Toos is probably saying to him that wherever it goes, I'm going to try and run a two to get back to your end. You've got to believe that wickets do make a difference in this match yet as well.
Blistering stroke. It's gone through extra cover like a rocket. And it's gone to the boundary. 3 runs needed from 2 balls. Makes it nice and tight, doesn't it? Got to get a single. Now, there'll be all sorts of conferences out there. There'll be between the batsmen, Reeve and Toos. There'll be between the captains and the fielders.
in the air and is safe. And Warwickshire have won a famous victory here at Lord's. A wonderful victory.
Well, in all the mayhem of that last ball, even though the stumps were out, they took two runs, so the final score, 322 for five. Delightful little partnership building up with Ostler and Paul Smith, and then that terrific run chase with Asif Din and Dermot Reeve putting on 142 in 141 balls. It's the highest score in a final. The bowlers, well, it was hard work. You could only feel sympathy for the bowlers. The best was Franklin Stevenson, but even he struggled to get control towards the end. 2 for 51 off his 12 overs. And so it is Warwickshire's day. Warwickshire won by 5 wickets, and the trophy was presented to Dermot Reeve along with a cheque for £30,000. David Gower chose the man of the match, and he ended up with his nomination, Asif Din.
Alan, first with a record score, you must have expected to have a rather comfortable victory, I suppose.
Well, I think at half time we were probably 4-0 up, weren't we? But two great innings from Asif and Dermot towards the end there. Magnificent innings, and unfortunately we were on the losing side.
Yeah, well, Alan said at half-time they were probably 4-0 up. I mean, you would have probably thought they were up even with the last over, and we needed 15 to win, and it was bad light. But, you know, it's a funny old game, cricket. It's a bit of a cliche for you, but, you know, I'm speechless. There you go.
Well, that really was an exhausting tale just to tell. I hope you've enjoyed our coverage of cricket during the summer. We've certainly enjoyed bringing it to you. From me and the rest of the team, for the moment, it's goodbye.
Richie Beno celebrates the outstanding careers of 12 of England's finest cricketers, featuring some of their greatest moments in Cricket's Entertainers from BBC Video.
Campaign, and